What's good? I'm Nash, and you're watching Vada Hang Chart.
I'd love to be a something to you. I'd love to be a something to you. I'd love to be a something to you.
Hey, what's up? I'm Nash.
The way you move, there's something in the way you groove, there's something.
So my stage name is Nash because my first name's Garrett and my last name's Nash, like N-A-S-H. So I just slid the G over, and G-N-A-S-H is actually, well, one, it has a silent G because that's how G's and N's work next to each other, but also it's an old English word that means to like gnash your teeth, like kind of like think pensively about something or chew something, and I thought that was kind of funny after I like figured out that that was going to be the name. So yeah, that's how I settled for it. I've been a DJ since I was about 13, and that's kind of how I got started in music. And then basically I just kept doing parties and different things for friends. And long story short, I ended up going to USC for college for music industry. And while I was there, I started to learn some production techniques and songwriting skills and things like that. And you know, growing up, I had learned Jack Johnson songs and a bunch of different stuff. So I've always been a fan. I just didn't know what capacity I was going to be involved in when it came to the business. So towards the end of college, I started making these covers to drop in my DJ sets of like Sugar Sugar by Baby Bash, and then the second one was Coco by OC Genesis. And people really liked the Coco one a lot. They liked both of them, but the Coco one started to get popping on SoundCloud. So I kind of just chased that and was like, oh, I have this idea to make 3 EPs. And yeah, that's kind of how I got going.
I hate you, I love you.
I Hate You, I Love You is definitely a wonderful thing because it brings so many people in. But then what's really awesome is that a lot of people seem to stay. And they keep listening and they come out to the shows, and everybody knows every word no matter where I am. We were in Hong Kong last night and the whole room sang along to everything. And it's cool because it's like, it's wonderful that that song exists, because like I said, so many people hear about me that way, and that's, I'm forever grateful for that. But then it's awesome because the music is so, it connects to so many people in so many different ways. And there may be a song that somebody connects with more than Hate You, Love You that they haven't even heard yet until they dive in on online or whatever and they find that song. So it's a beautiful thing, man. I'm really happy that everything's gone how it has. I have no complaints whatsoever. Yeah, essentially, so I have 3 EPs out called You, Me, and Us, and to me, You, Me, and Us are a walk through a breakup with you, and then finding yourself with me, and then Us is finding something new, but it's also kind of represents the universality of the journey that the music goes through. And I went through a breakup, and I had this idea to do the 3 EPs because I wanted to document what I was feeling so that if somebody else were ever in my position and felt the way I did, they would have something to listen to feel better. Because I have this theory that if we feel together, we'll feel better. And also that I just want to let people know they're not alone. So that was a big thing for me with making You, Me, and Us. And every EP in itself has a story, and people have their own meanings for things like that. But that's the generalized story, and then everything kind of rolls into that. Yeah, we did a festival in South Korea, and that was actually the first time I ever headlined something, a festival, which was awesome. I've had headlining tours, but not festivals. And then we did 2 headlining shows in Shanghai and Hong Kong, and both of those were incredible. Smaller rooms, like 300 or so, but still, like, it felt like my first run in America. It was awesome. And now we're here. You know, I do this thing when I travel that's kind of like, this has like a this vibe to it, or this has a this vibe, you know what I mean? So like Hong Kong, for example, to us was like somewhere between like Paris, New York, and Hawaii, and like that may be totally wrong, but like when you're driving to dinner and you get to see 3 buildings, you're like, oh, this feels like, you know. So far it's just been a lot of that, and then usually what'll happen is I'll get home and I'll have time to recollect my thoughts, and I'll be like, man, that was an incredible place, you know? And in the moment, a lot of it's breathtaking, because there's just so many things I've never seen before. The birds that fly by, and the trees, and the weather is crazy, and you know, it's wonderful. Traveling is always a sensory thing, because that coupled with jet lag and a lack of sleep because of these shows, I'm feeling weird, but it's cool.
Or maybe a daisy, because lately you seem into those. All right, start dancing, here we go. I guess that works for
me. First impression is I love the food here, but I already knew that. So like coming into Thailand, I was like, man, I'm gonna be eating good there. So I basically just came here. We did sound check this morning. I landed this morning, we did sound check. I went back to the hotel, downed a bunch of fried rice and pad thai. I feel incredible. And yeah, I love it. What's good to all my Thai dreamers? I just wanted to say hey, and I love you, and I'm super happy to come back next time and get to meet all you guys. And in the meantime, I'm here right now, and I love your country. Thank you for having me.
To be something to you. I'd love to be a something to you. I'd love to be be a something to you.